This is Sea Siren ASMR, and for today's video, I'm going to read you a bedtime story. Sleeping Beauty. Sleeping Beauties is about a woman who's immune to a sleeping curse in a world full of sleeping women. It's a man's world, and she is the only woman. These are cinnamon incense that I made myself. The lighter. I'm so pleased it works after all these many months since I've made this cinnamon incense. And it smells like cinnamon. tapping on glass. I want to hear that again. It's so haunting. Undecided if I want to start reading this entire book ASMR. Stephen King, Sleeping Beauties. This is a haunting book about a woman who is immune to a sleeping curse. Meanwhile, every other woman in the world falls asleep and doesn't wake up. Her name is Eva Black. In a future so real and near, it might be now. A mysterious pandemic is causing women everywhere to suddenly go to sleep. Shrouded in a cocoon-like gauze, any attempt to awaken them is met with a reaction of feral, spectacular violence. And while they sleep, the women go into another place, a better place, where harmony prevails and conflict is rare. But there is only one enigmatic. Eve Black, who is immune to the blessing or curse of the sleeping disease. Is Eve a medical anomaly to be studied, or a demon that must be slain? Meanwhile, the men abandoned, left to their increasing primal urges, left to their increasingly primal urges are dividing into wearing factions. Some of them want to kill Eve, and some want to save her. Even as others rise up and exploit the chaos to wreak their own vengeance on new enemies in this brutal, suddenly all-male world. Sleeping Beauties. The moth makes Eve laugh. It lands in her own forearm, and she brushes her index finger lightly across the brown and gray waves that color its wings. "Hello, gorgeous," she tells the moth. Upward, upward, and upward the moth goes, and is swallowed by a slice of sun tangled amid the glassy green leaves 20 feet above Eve's place among the ground. A coppery red leaks from a black socket at the center of the trunk and twists between plates of bark. Evie doesn't trust the snake, obviously. She had trouble with him before. So Eve doesn't trust the snake. Her moth and 10,000 others surge from the treetop in a crackling, dun-colored cloud. The swarm rolls across the sky in the direction of the sickly second growth pines on the other side of the meadow. She rises to follow. Stalks crunch under her steps, and the waist-high grass scrapes her bare skin. As she approaches the sad, mostly logged over wood, she detects the first chemical smells: ammonia, benzoin, petroleum, so many others. 10,000 nicks on a single patch of flesh, and relinquishes the hope she had not realized she harmed. Webs spill from her fingertips and sparkle in the morning light. "I'd like to show you something. A real haunting story. This is a friend of mine. Her name is Angel. This is a self-portrait. She was a photographer. The photo looks like a ghost. Angel gave me this photo and some other gifts a couple of days before she died. This is something else that Angel gave me before she died. Tahitian black pearls. She just gave them to me. Then she died. I've cherished them for 20 years. So I find it pretty haunting that Angel gave me a self-portrait, a necklace, a Tahitian pearl necklace, Tahitian pearl necklace, Tahitian pearl necklace, and a book. Before she died. And a book. The book is called The Claiming of Sleeping Beauty. These were Angel's gifts to me a couple of nights before she died. Did she have a premonition? I was very surprised that she was giving me all of these personal treasures. Anne Rice. Anne Rice is one of my favorite authors. And coincidentally, Stephen King's Sleeping Beauty. Sleeping Beauties. Today, too. These books will be treasured. delicate hourglass, very thin glass. These are iron shavings instead of sand. Anyway, it's magnetized. So the magnetic energy field is drawing it down, pulls it with the gravity. This is a very special crystal. This crystal was given to me as a gift about 30 years ago, along with the stand, the pewter stand. The problem is, I don't remember the name of this crystal. So if anybody could help me, please let me know the name of this crystal. So look at this flash. This flash is on the complete opposite side of the crystal as well. See that? It's supposed to be the polar opposites. North and south. North and south. This is why this crystal is so, it's rare and amazing. so below as above. So below. As above, so below. As above, so below. Three times three. 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 But not least, here's some candy for your trick-or-treaters. Trick-or-treat, smell my feet, give me something good to eat.